The reason I'm pulling you over is your derogatory sticker on the back of your truck.
It was just three words, but the officer thought it went too far. That Florida man was arrested for his bumper sticker. Then the charges were dropped as he defended himself using the First Amendment. This guy had that bumper sticker on his car. We can't say what it says. The first two words are I eat, and you can maybe fill in the rest based off of the picture.
Think donkey. And that's why the deputy said he pulled him over. He felt it goes against Florida's obscenity law. But the driver has free speech on his side, so just this week, a prosecutor decided the charges were against that man's First Amendment rights. So ABC 7 wanted to know, what is considered too obscene? Our Ben Henry set out to get the answer.
We've got an example right here, our station vehicles. ABC 7, get more. Short, simple, and not inappropriate. But that's not always the case for some people. But that also doesn't mean they can't have it on their car. So we went out and asked, how far is too far?
It's safe to say someone's love for their dog is good to go, even a pro football team. But that line of what's obscene and what's not is tricky to find. Take this one, for example. A lot of people in Florida and certain fans in Alabama would find this extremely offensive.
Our country has always been, you know, wonderful in the fact that we're able to have free speech.
For Noelle Teets, she does her best to keep the raunch away from her kids and niece, but says our free speech is important.
On the other side, I don't like my children to see things like that.
And that, of course, is Dylan Webb's window sticker.
You're not infringing my First Amendment right.
Highlighting a snack of his. One Columbia County deputy didn't feel like it belonged on the street.
1026.
Webb was cited, even booked for not getting rid of it, but now he's free.
The difficulty with obscenity is it's extremely tricky to define.
Elizette Velada with Goldberg Noon says he's free because of his free speech. A judge felt the same, clearing the charge and citing his right to the First Amendment. That, Velada says, likely not an easy decision.
You're looking case by case. You're trying to draw analogies between past cases and current cases and trying to define what an entire community considers offensive.
In Florida, obscenity must, as Velada says, be considered that by the general public, making that line hard to find and easy to cross, as what may be offensive for you is not to another. In Lee County, Ben Henry, ABC 7.